Toronto Argonauts beat the Edmonton Eskimos 42-26 on Sunday at Rogers Centre. They're on their way to the East Division Final. Steve, you think this game came down to turnovers or lack thereof?
Well, I think change of it, for certainly change of momentum. Three, really, when you count the interception. But the fumble recovery by Flemons, that was important at the time. And then it was really a 14-point play when Chad Hackert. I've never seen a play like this on third and one where the fumble is so far away from the original point. Hackert just happened to get lucky. Somebody yelled fumble, and he recovered it. I think that probably goes the other way, perhaps for another six. It would have been 14-0 at that point. And really, momentum was this entire game was momentum, and those two gave the Argos momentum. They scored three touchdowns in a very short period of time, and that essentially put the game away.
The Argos scored a CFL playoff record 31 points in the second quarter, which really put the game away for them. Edmonton, obviously, very disappointing loss for them. Matt Nichols injured. They fired their general manager. That is a team in disarray.
Complete disarray, and the season ending doesn't end that disarray. In fact, it compounds it, because now it's all about developing that front office. The front office, and I think this goes way back to Danny Machocha's time, it just isn't the same as it was in those 30-plus years. It's not as dependable, and I don't know how much of that comes from the community-oriented governing board, or whether it just isn't in the GM suites. I don't think so. I think there's real problems there. It's not the way Edmonton has run its team. The last 5 or 6 years, this isn't the way that Edmonton has run the Eskimos.
Now, the Argonauts will go to Montreal next Sunday to take on the Alouettes in the East Division Final. And, Steve, do the Argos have a chance to win that game?
Yes, they have. It's absolutely important that they do what they did today. Ball control, Kackert. Ricky Ray, really, didn't have like a 350-yard gain, but he was he 23 for 30? And, you know, in the mid-200s, it was a lot of precision plays. Going underneath, taking advantage of Sherritt not being there. If they do that same kind of intelligence, and I think they've got... Milanovic was playing this down. People were asking, does he have any advantages going into his old place as coach? He says no. Well, I think they got an advantage because Scott Milanovic is their coach, not necessarily because he's going back into Montreal. I really, really, really like what this guy's done with his team and the feeling that it gives him. Every single time they get some kind of break, they jump on it. They made big use of the turnovers today. 14 points, I think, off the first three turnovers. They also, if they play a ball control game, the big thing is don't get behind and then put pressure on that secondary, because under a lot of pressure on the Montreal secondary, what do? They hold, and they get caught now. They didn't used to get caught, and now they do.
Make sure you check out Monday Spectator for a full game story, and Steve's column as well, and the Scratching Post blog for all your up-to-the-minute CFL news now. Reporting from the Rogers Centre with the Spec, Steve Milton, I'm Drew Edwards.